This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. Here's our next motion problem, or you can think of it as a rate times distance problem. Remember, rate times time equals distance. All right, so we've got Andy and Beth are at opposite ends of an 18-mile country road, with plans to leave at the same time, running toward each other to meet. Andy runs 7 miles per hour while Beth runs 5 miles per hour. How long after they begin will they meet? So when it says how long after they begin will they meet, it means we're going to be looking for their time, right? But let's begin with the picture. We've got a country road that is 18 miles long. And we have Andy at one end and Beth at the other end, and they run toward each other. Now, Andy's running 7 miles per hour. We're not going to put that in here, but we do know that means he's going faster, so he's going to go past the halfway mark. So this is just the picture. Okay, so we'll just say this is where they're going to meet. All right, so now we want to put some information in a chart to keep track of their rate and their time and their distance. So we have Andy and Beth, rate, time, and distance. And are there rates given? Okay, so Andy, it says Andy runs 7 miles per hour, so yes, his is given, and it's 7. Beth runs 5 miles per hour, so that number is given as well. Hey, by the way, feel free to put the video on pause and try the rest of it all on your own. This is a little bit easier than the other problems I've done so far. What about their time? I know nothing about their time except that they leave at the same time and then they meet each other, which actually is a lot of information. It means whatever their time is, it's the same amount of time. They're both running for the exact same amount of time. So I'm going to define X to be Andy's time, but it's the same for Beth's time. They both are running for the same length of time. All right, so the formula is rate times time is equal to distance, so we just multiply to get the distance for Andy. 7 times x is 7x, and Beth, 5 times x is 5x. Okay, so I didn't need all this space here. Okay, so we could take, and now we go up to the picture, and we're going to put the distance where we're representing it up here. So Andy, 7x, that means this line segment from here to here is 7x. That's how long that is. And then Beth, her distance from here to here is 5x. So we look at the picture, right? You say, can you make an equation from that? And hopefully you see it, that this distance from here to here plus this distance from here to here is the same as the total distance of 18 miles. So we get the equation 7x plus 5x equals 18. All right, that was pretty simple to solve. We've got like terms, so we have 12x is 18. And then we can divide both sides by 12. Solve for x. All right, now 18 twelfths. You could either reduce it first, change to a mixed number, do long division, it's up to you. I'm going to go ahead and reduce it. 6 goes into both numbers, so 18 divided by 6 is 3, and 12 divided by 6 is 2. So 3 halves, well, since we're talking about time, it makes sense to either write that as 1.5 or 1.5, because we're talking about hours, right? X happens to be time in hours. So 1.5 or 1.5. It doesn't matter which way you write it. And you could have left it as 3 halves, but usually you don't say, oh, I ran for 3 halves hours. You know, you say I ran for 1.5 hours or 1.5 hours. Okay, so now let's check to make sure this all makes sense. So we're going to take this chart again, and now we're going to fill in X since we know it. So we've got A, Andy, and Beth. The rate we already knew was 7 and 5, but now we know what the time is. It's 1.5 or 1.5. I'm just going to go ahead and put in 1.5. Okay. And that'll give us, when we multiply 7 times 1.5, we'll have the distance. So you can go on the side and do your work, 7 times 1.5, or get out a calculator, and that's 10.5. So 10.5 miles. And that seems reasonable. You're going 7 miles an hour for 1.5 hours. Well, 7 plus half of that is 3.5 more, so that makes sense. And also, you do the same thing for 5 times 1.5 hours. You're going to go 5 miles for the first hour and 2.5 more miles. That's going to be 7.5. So you could figure it out that way. Go over and do your arithmetic on the side with decimals or with fractions or with a calculator. It's up to you. So this chart tells us the rate, times, and distance. We want to make sure that makes sense according to our picture we had up here. So let's see. For the picture, we had Andy and Beth, and now we're saying, you know, that's 18 miles, right? We're saying Andy's portion is 10.5 miles, and Beth's ran, her part over here, was 7.5 miles. So the question is, does that add up? Is 10.5 plus 7.5 equal to 18? So is 10.5 plus 7.5, 18, and yes, it does add up. So our answer makes sense. So now we want to go and answer the right question. So here's the original question. How long after they begin will they meet? Well, that means it just wants to know the amount of time, right? And the time, well, it was only 1.5 hour. They both just ran 1.5 hours, right? So they met up after 1.5 hours. So that's our final answer. You could say 1.5 hours, or you could put 1.5 hours. Just depends how you want to write that. You could say they meet after 90 minutes. All means the same thing. All right, now it's care you have to be careful here. It might have said, how far did Andy run? And of course, then you would look at the distance and say, oh, you know, how long, how far? You would say 10.5 miles. If it asked how long Beth ran, you would say 7.5 miles. Right? So make sure you go back and do answer the question. And again, try this problem all on your own. And if you need help, then just go back and watch the video again. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.